Perfect. We are live on YouTube. So let's begin as usual with a word of prayer. Then we can start our session for the day. Father, Lord Almighty, we bless your name. We give you glory. We give you all the praise. Mighty and everlasting Redeemer, you alone are God. You alone are faithful. Thank you, Lord, for all of us, Jehovah, Lord. In this meeting, Jehovah, Lord, as we get in to learn, Jehovah, Father, how we pray that your guidance will lead us, how we pray that your presence will go before us, O Lord. Mighty and everlasting Redeemer, we pray for your wisdom to reign upon us, O Lord. We pray, yes, for our mentor, as he mentors us, Jehovah, Lord, today. We pray for him, Jehovah, Lord, that you enrich him with wisdom and knowledge and understanding, Jehovah, Father. We give you glory and honor, Jehovah, Lord. We pray for every gadget, we pray for every connectivity, Jehovah, Lord, that it shall be well, Jehovah, Lord, and the connectivity will be very smart, Jehovah Father, as we continue, Jehovah King of all glory. We pray, Jehovah Lord, that none of us will drop because of the in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Father, we bless you. For it is in Jesus' holy name we pray and believe. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Wow. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Nagilai. And thank you, everyone. I can see people are joining fast and furious. My apologies for getting 30 minutes later. So, yeah, we were traveling, but we have a solid 30 minutes whereby we can be able to learn something and pick it and move. So we thank God for all the participants. I can see Waithaka Kevin, Karibu Sana. I can see Jamokes. That's a phone. And of course, I can see Nagilai. I can see Josephine Kimani. I can see Favor Obasike. This guy is always on time. Thank you, Favor. All the way from the US of A. I hope that you are doing well. I can see my good friend, Brian Simiu, Asante Sana, Brian Simiu. Daisy Kabinu. Asante Sana. I can see Pelis right there. I can see Beth. I can see John Muregi. You know, nice photo. I can see Pelis right there. And I can see John, I can see I can see Peles Agola, and I can see Chelangat right there. So the rest will catch up with us as we move on to discover on how to thrive in sales. And thank you, Catherine, Karibu Sana, how to thrive in sales and also how to thrive in marketing, because we are all salespeople, we are marketers, whatever we are doing. Those who are doing the blogs, you know, I read one of the blogs from Winamo, fantastic blog. So we are on the run in terms of converting prospects, converting leads and selling. And one of the things on how to thrive in sales is what we are doing here, training and mentorship. That's why we are here, to learn, to see how does George actually does it? How do we do it? You know, and one of the ways is training. I remember when I was a young salesperson, you know, I enrolled in a diploma in sales and marketing, and I learned a lot of things. And that's why for me, when we are hiring marketers or salespeople, and I ask you a question, you know, tell us the 7 P's of marketing. If you start fumbling, I know where is your marketer, you can't sell. So these are basic needs for the team here, that you must understand the 7 P's of marketing. So very, very important. So one of the things is basically training. And that's what we are doing in the next 30 minutes, in this mentorship, in this training that we always have. And of course, if you want to drive in sales, especially those who are leading their own organizations, one of the things that has worked for me, you know, I always make a joke with the people that I work with, that at 1 month, you know, for 1 month, there was a time I sold 30 properties. And I always challenge them, who can challenge George in terms of selling? You know, 30 plots in a month, not 2 months, in a month. And that's usually a challenge for the people that we hire. But I've also discovered that now we have many properties. So George will surely not sell 100 properties in a month. So what is this trick for Optivate to thrive in sales? The trick is get people like you, people who can sell even better like you. And that's how we got people now joining the movement to ensure that the selling is happening. The same with you, with your venture. You can be able to tap these talents and keep thriving in terms of selling. And of course, you have options. You can either get indirect salespeople, at OptiVent, we call them ambassadors. These are people who love the brand. They can be able to talk well about our products. They call ambassadors. You can also get part-time people, people who support Catherine. Maybe they support what you do, so that when Catherine posts something on social media, these are your top fans. You know, they can be able to tell other people what Catherine is doing. Very interesting. And of course, if you have resources, if God has blessed you with resources, you can now hire full-time what we do at OptiVent. You know, I remember, yes, I think the day before yesterday, you know, last week also, we were getting almost 4 or 5 hours interviewing marketers. Why? Because we want to engage them on full-time. That's how to thrive in sales. And of course, you as an individual, you need to maintain what I call the positive relationship with your prospects. Prospects, they are nearing suspects. They have not come in to buy your service or your product, but they have potential. And I remember one time I was training my team, and I was telling them, even if somebody is not buying today, is a prospect. And I remember one time, you know, one of the colleagues giving an example that she maintained a prospect for 4 years without buying anything. The fourth year, the prospect came and bought 4 properties cash. Can you imagine? That's how people thrive, by maintaining positive relationship. Even if a prospect is not enthusiastic today, who knows about tomorrow? They can be able to come in and consume your product, consume your service. So, Mr. Waidaka, so all the time, maintain that positive relationship with the people that you have. And of course, as a salesperson, remain consistent. Yeah, remain consistent. Don't be like a river that flows all over. Remain consistent. Be consistent. Keep your value preposition. What do you believe in? You know, if you ask OptiVent, we say, we believe in housing Kenyans. We believe that we are the company to house every Kenyan. Remain in your what you believe in. Yeah. I always say that selling is not like a catwalk whereby you go to carnival, you see some entertainment, then you walk home. No. Selling is not a catwalk. It is a relationship. It is persistence. It is endurance. You have to be patient. So build yourself. Build that personal brand. Build that personal brand so that when people see Chris Jao, they can say that color green remains the color of prosperity. That's your brand. That's why I tell people that if you're not yet composed very well, you need to compose your venture to ensure that the brand is visible. Maybe you are saying, George Bwana, me, I'm a new person. I'm in school. I'm aware that we have some students here who are in the university, and they want to be the best sellers, the best salespeople. This is what you can do if you are new in selling. This is what you can do. You need to identify your goal and then work backwards. So if you are saying, me as Chris Jao, this month of October, I want to close 3 million worth of sales. And then you work backwards. What do I need to do? How many cold calling should I do? How many offices should I knock? How many posts on the social media should I do? And how do I develop lead generation? How do I develop my funnel, my sales funnel? Identify your goal. If you're a salesperson, you have no goal, I can tell you. The month of October will end and you'll not have sold anything. If you're a new person, number two, recognize that sales is a process. Don't give up on the way. Sales is a process. That's why we also always talk about the funnel. You know, what are you putting in? How many people are you talking to? How many Facebook groups are you in? And for you to thrive, definitely you must realize that the sales is a process. It's not hit and run. No, it's a process. Identify the customer in. If it is Benix, I got, you are talking to a customer. What is the real need of this particular customer? You know, I one time I took my friend, you know, to buy a coffee. and somebody had died, you know, and we went to do selection. You know, the guy that we found selling coffins, he took us directly to the cheapest. Yet, I knew my friend wanted to buy the state-of-the-art coffin for the father. And he was even telling me, I wish I can get a coffin that costs 200,000. This fellow took us to a coffin that cost 30,000. And I could see the annoyance of this guy. Why did this salesperson took us the cheapest? Because he did not talk to us to understand what we are looking for and also to know the profile of the prospect. And this one thing I urge all of us, know your prospect. Know your customer well so that you can identify what are their pain points. What are they looking for? And I am aware that some people here sell properties. So never take a customer to more than three projects, because once you take them to more than three projects, Mr. Gabriel, it means they'll get confused. Listen to this particular customer. Unajua huyu ni mudosi. Huyu ni mtu ya this particular property. Take them to the right product, to the right service. Very, very important. That's why you find that even when you go to supermarkets, there are some people who cannot enter into certain supermarkets because that's not their class. So you as a salesperson, you must identify the class of your prospect, identify the pain points. Of course, number four, enable your team members, the team you work with. I know some people have got teams they are working with. Enable them also to sell, support them. That one, as you support them, you also thrive in selling. You also thrive because the hand that gives also receives. Number five, shadow your new people that you are supporting. If you are a business owner, ask the people who are selling to accompany you to hear, to feel how you pitch. They say success can be copied. Once they hear how you pitch, I can tell you they can pitch like you. Very, very interesting. Those who are maybe new in a certain product, identify the person who shines in that particular service, that particular product, and tell them, today I want to take a walk with you. I'm going to walk with you. Listen how they speak, how they do it, how they close the deals. That way, you thrive in sales. And then you can find a mentor. Find a mentor. Mentors help us to learn five times more than literally reading, you know, walking with someone. Find a mentor. Allow me to share with you one of the powerful things I've done in sales. And I call it, you know, a very powerful skill. I call it C, yani S-E-A. It's a C. You know, I call it the C strategy. And this C strategy has worked for me. It can work for you. The C strategy, S-E-A. The C strategy means that you as a salesperson, you must be sincere. Sincerity is key in selling. Listen without an agenda. When a customer comes to speak to you, listen to the customer without a preformed or a certain mind. Listen without an agenda. Why? Selling a product or service is not about you. It's about the customer. You must be sincere that if it is Lea Nyambula, you are talking to maybe Nagilai, and you want to understand what Nagirai wants. Be sincere. Don't go there with an agenda. Maybe you're selling shoes and you want to push the black shoes to Nagirai. Yet, Nagirai is from my community. They like red. Can you listen sincerely from Nagirai to understand that red is key for him? We call it sincerity. That way, that strategy work. The time you remove a red shoe, the price won't matter. Nagirai will tell you, how much are you selling? And then, do you take money on M-Pesa? Or do you have a PayView? You get your money. But most of the things that what we do is that we go with preconceptions. You are pushing things to people, and people don't want these things because you're not sincere, you have not listened to them. The C strategy, E. E stands for ethics. Ethics. Listen to what the customer really wants. Be ethical enough to identify and to listen and to observe what the customer wants. Let me tell you a secret. If you're a salesperson, if you find yourself selling something that a customer doesn't want, I can tell you, you will sweat, you have complications in selling. But if you're ethical enough, you are good enough to listen to the customer, you can identify what this customer wants. The C strategy, A means asking. The C strategy, A means asking, you know, serve your customer by asking intelligent questions. A means asking. Ask intelligent questions. Maybe you want to sell a computer, for example. And then, of course, there are many brands of computers. You can ask the customer. Assume the customer is Mary Murimi, and maybe the seller is Gabriel. Gabriel asks Mary Murimi, by the way, which is your favorite brand in terms of laptops? And then this guy will tell you, maybe Max, maybe Apple, maybe Tech, or different brands. By Mary telling you the brand, you can almost tell how the pocket of Mary is. Because you know, this brand is slightly more expensive. If you're doing real estate, you can ask them, by the way, which area within Nairobi metropolis do you prefer to live in? And then they'll tell you, if I get something in Kiambu or Lavington or Karen, definitely you'll be able to identify the need of this customer by asking an intelligent question. Who unto you if you ask a stupid question? Because you can also lose a sale. Yeah. You see, this is a guy who has come driving a BMW, and then you're telling them, by the way, I have a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful plot in Makueni. Jamata haja itabea Makueni. So you lose it. So that's why the C strategy can work for you. It has worked for me. But they also say, you also request as a salesperson to be a keen listener. Let me train you or teach you how you can be a very effective, not only keen listener, but effective listener. Why? We are saying sales requires listening, sales requires asking. How can you be an effective listener? I'll share with you like five pointers on how you, as Anthony Kimohu, you can be effective listener. Number one, assuming that Anthony has gone to sell something to somebody, and that somebody is there, the person is actually there, what do you need to do? Face the person and maintain eye contact. Yeah. Don't touch your phone. Face the person or the customer or the people, the person speaking to you, and maintain the eye contact. That is very important because you'll be able to observe the nonverbal. Number two, be attentive and also be relaxed. Yeah. When you are listening, be attentive, also relax. So if you had issues disturbing you, drop them. Just be relaxed, listen to the customer, be attentive. And let me tell you, the customer can tell when you're not attentive. The customer can tell. If the customer comes to your desk, now you are busy with your laptop, number one, you can lose it. You go to see a customer, you are busy on your phone, you lose it because you are not there. The body is there, but you're not paying attention. So we lose things very easily. Other people, you go to see a customer, even before you know the customer, you are removing your business card. That's bad manners. Who asked you for a business card? The business card should come towards the end. First of all, be like a doctor. When you go to a clinic, the doctor asks you, wow, welcome. What is your name? What do you do? What are you feeling? So you now, the doctor is able to listen to you. The same with a salesperson. Be a doctor. Listen to your customer. Pay attention. Number three, keep your mind open. Every time you go to talk to a customer, Buena Benix, every time you go to talk to a customer, keep your mind open. How? The customer may come with some other stories. The customer may be having some challenges. So don't be a judge. Don't judge a customer. Don't go quickly and jump into conclusions. No. Don't judge a book by its cover. Maybe you have met a customer there, you say, this one cannot be able to buy. You are now doing a judgment. You never know. Let me give you a story. You know, one time I was a sales agent for houses. And there was this young guy who came with the torn jeans. The jeans were torn. And the guy told me, I am looking for a beautiful apartment worth about 30 million. You know, I look at the guy. I saw the jeans were torn. And I knew this fellow. This fellow must be joking. I was taught by my teacher, by my professor Kibera, never judge a customer. So we went and saw the apartment. As if it was a movie, the guy told me, actually, I want four of them. Can I get four next to one another in this apartment? I said, this guy crazy? I looked at him again with a torn jeans. Little did I know, this guy was working for Google in the US of A. So he had come purposely to Kenya to buy apartments for renters. What saved me? Because I was not judgmental. And from that example, I urge all of you as salespeople, never ever judge your clients. Finally, to have an open mind, don't be a sentence grabber. What do I mean by being a sentence grabber? What do I mean? Sentence grabber means when somebody is speaking, maybe somebody is speaking to Catherine. You know, there are people nationally, they are slow. Maybe the way they were born. Maybe they delayed during birth. So they are slow. Don't finish sentences for them. Be patient. Let them finish the sentences. Let them finish talking about their request. Or don't say, or you want an apartment, you want this, you want this product, you want this. No, let them finish. Don't grab people's sentences. The same with families. There are families who cannot wait for the spouse to finish a sentence. They finish for them. That is terrible thing. You know, that is not good at all, especially in selling. Wow. Number four, listen to the words and try to picture what client is saying. Listen to client words. And then have a picture. This client, what are they saying? If they say something like Favor Obaseke, and you are listening to this particular client who want a whole package in terms of social media, you know, do they want a page, a Facebook, an Instagram, a TikTok? You know, have a picture of what the customer wants. Once you grab that picture, definitely by the time they finish talking, you are able to offer the solution per the customer's pain point. Number five, how to be effective listener. Number five, don't interrupt and don't impose your solution to a customer. Man, don't impose your solutions to the customer. What happens when you impose a solution to the customer? If the customer is looking for a Twitter account, and then Favor is telling the customer, I can offer you TikTok. Maybe this customer doesn't like TikTok. Listen and then identify and don't impose the solution to the customer. Because when you impose, what happens? The customer think you don't value their opinions. And let me tell you, it is what customer values, is their opinions. You must value their opinions. If you interrupt, the customer think you don't care. And you know, for a salesperson, we care. We care about our customers. Number six, ask questions only to ensure your understanding. Where you're not very clear and the customer is speaking, just ask where you think is more, you need more understanding. Maybe somebody is asking, Chris, by the way, this property in Kiambu, what values are you adding? Maybe you can ask, by the way, are there some specific values that you're looking for? Maybe you need a sewer system, You need underground power. So ask to understand more until the customer completely finishes the presentation, and then you pick it up. Finally, summarize, summarize, summarize. Every time you meet a customer and you have finished listening, you can now summarize. And then you can tell the customer, wow. You can tell the customer, I want to use a name here. Assuming that, let me see, Joy Kenya is the customer. You say, wow, Joy, thank you very much. Now I understand what you are looking for. I know that you are looking for a property in Kitengela. And we can be able to offer solutions. And summarize, summarize means it can be immediate summary when you're talking, or it could be a text. Every time you call a customer, summarize the discussions. Every time you talk to a customer, summarize a discussion on an email. Maybe you're looking for a certain product. Maybe you're looking for somebody to develop your blog. You tell Muinamo, you know, maybe it's Muinamo looking for somebody to develop the blog. So you say, dear Anthony Kemohu, thank you for the discussions. I am able to develop 2 blogs per week. And these blogs per week can be able to generate you this number of leads. So always summarize the discussions. Very important. I don't know whether you're aware that sometimes you think you have closed a deal only for a person to tell you, no, I did not mean that. That's why it's very, very important for a salesperson to summarize. Wow, I can see the time is really running fast. Allow me to share with you 3 things on how to thrive in marketing. I was talking about the sales. Now let's talk about marketing. How do you thrive? You don't need to survive. You need to thrive. You need to prosper. You need to really, really prosper to do well in marketing. Number one, you as a person, be a megaphone. A megaphone means your voice is out there in the market. If you are running maybe a certain shop, everybody needs to know on your platform what you offer. Be your own megaphone. If you are working with teams, let your teams be megaphone. So even I like the way some people are becoming very good megaphones on the platform. I saw Muinamo say, before the mentor comes, read this blog. That's being megaphone. That means you might read that particular blog and say, wait a minute, can you craft for me blogs relating to my business? Because blogs are also one way of harnessing and harvesting leads. How to thrive in marketing? Number 2, always study the trends. Study the trends. Research. That way you thrive. We are living in a very, very fast changing environment. And I really sympathize with the people who are now doing the old media, the newspapers, you know, the TV, because now everybody, we are actually on TV right now. This is our own TV of mentorship. So you need to study the trend and then know how do you capture your market. Otherwise, if you're not very careful, those who are in Kenya, you know Telecom. You know, Telecom was a huge, big company. And for you to apply for a phone, you are pleading with them. Today, they send almost 70% of their staff home. It was once a giant, now it's no longer there. The same with us. So if you don't study the trends, you can easily close the door. Now, can I give me the 5 more minutes? Number 3, learn to be a storyteller. You can't be in marketing, you don't tell stories. Some customers can already understand storytelling. Do it in writing, do it in text, do it in talking. Learn to be a storyteller. Number 4, use data to make decisions as a marketer. Use data to make decisions. That's why in marketing, surveys are good. Checking your people is good. Update is good. Data is equal to money. Data is equal to money. Use data to make decisions. Love technology. Number 5, love technology. Love technology. You can't do much nowadays without the help, the leverage of technology. Never stop learning. Never, never stop learning. Finally, as I conclude, finally, allow me to share with you 4 strategies in being a good marketer. 4 strategies that will make you thrive in marketing. 4 strategies. Number 1, and this one I use it. Number 1, this is what I call the course marketing. The course marketing, C-A-U-S-E, the course marketing. Why should people buy your product or service? The cost marketing means you relate your product or service with a social cost. Yeah? You relate your product or service with a social cost. This is a good example for Optivate. We run a foundation. The other day, somebody called me and told me, George, the reason why I'm buying a property in Kiambu is because I saw your program that is called Mobility That Brings a Smile. So they are buying because once they buy, they become philanthropists. The cost marketing. Maybe you can ask yourself, do you have a cost that customers can buy that cost so that they are able to buy your service or product? Number two strategy, relationship marketing. Yeah, relationship marketing. This focuses on a customer retention and satisfaction. It also promotes customers' loyalty, developing relationship. Don't be transactional as a marketer. Relate with the people. Call them up. Check them out. Relationship marketing. Develop loyalty. Number three, scarcity marketing. If Muteti was here, he likes this. Scarcity marketing means you lead to a customer knowing that if they don't purchase, the stocks are going to be completely over. The fear of missing. They fear missing. Scarcity marketing. And those who are in the properties, don't show a customer that you have a whole 50 plots. No, you tell them this property is scarce. People are coming for it. The scarcity marketing. Those who are in social media, tell your customer, if you miss this tool, next year, Google is adding price on this particular tool. The scarcity marketing. Finally, it's called undercover marketing. Undercover marketing strategy. You present in a way that the customer may not know that you are selling. And undercover marketing, personally, I use it. When I go for TV shows, maybe I go to KTN or NTV. Of course, you are instructed, don't come to market here. But when I give examples, when I talk about how Kenyan economy is performing, now I could Optivate. I could maybe our project. That is undercover marketing. And once you do that, I can tell you, you'll be thriving in marketing. You'll be thriving in sales. I think I'll put a full stop there or a comma. I know that I have really rushed, you know. In Kikambo, you say, kanini kaseo, you know, it's a short but sweet, kanini kaseo. And I think we'll stop there and then give it back to Mr. Maglai.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. We really appreciate. Yes, this is a great afternoon. I believe we've learned a lot this afternoon. Yes, it may be short, but it was on point. Anybody with a question, you can type there or you can just unmute yourself and talk so that we can finish in the next 5 minutes will be done, at most 5 minutes. So anybody with a question, I can see Favor says, thank you, sir. I can see Muremi says, thank you, sir. Thank you very much, our mentor. It is short session, but very educative. Anthony Kimho says, that was powerful. Josephine Kimani says, much learning within a very short time. Yusla says, thank you, sir. It was short, but very powerful. Yes, if you have any question, you can post there. And if we don't have any question, yes, we will be done in the next 3 minutes then. I can see, let me read comments. I can see Anthony Ngure says, thank you very much, sir. That session was very powerful. Catherine says, short but profound. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you. Jumoke says, thank you, sir. And then we have John Murigi says, this is powerful. Has COVID lowered the rate of closing deals? That is a question. He says, has COVID lowered the rate of closing deals, or it's just to me? So that is John Murigi. You can handle that, sir, as we look forward for others.
Wow, thank you. Thank you, John. Thank you, John Murigi. I would say that for us, I can speak for those who are in real estate, like Optivate, I think we have not seen the lowering of closing deals. but he have also gone an extra mile to tap new markets, and especially the markets that were favored by COVID. You know, there are many markets that were favored by COVID, and of course, the areas of health, the areas of sanitation, and we targeted those particular areas. So for us who are doing real estate, we have not really seen it. And also including, you know, for us at Octaven, we have hired more people during COVID than even before COVID. So I think either God's favor or something. But of course, I'm also aware that we also run restaurants. And for restaurants, we have seen decline in terms of leading closing deals for people who want to eat and to be entertained. So it all depends on the sector that you are in, John. I need to check which sector you are in. But even if the deals closure have gone down, you can try to explore new market. We call the blue ocean. You can check where you can be able to find the blue ocean. Thank you, John.
Thank you, sir. That was great. I can see more. These are not questions. They are just, they are good comments. Leah Nyambura says, profound. Thank you, sir. Mary Muremi says, thank you, sir. Brian Simiu says, learning a lot. Emily Masiga Wangira says, thank you, sir. Then we have Chris Njao says, emphasis on active learning. It works. Good. That was great. That was profound indeed. Yes, right about now, we are done for our session today. We really appreciate you guys. Keep on tuning in. Next week, I have an announcement to make. Next week, we are meeting at 4 p.m. We will let you know. In case of any other changes, I will communicate in our groups. Thank you, guys. God bless you. We value you. We value you. Asante sana. God bless you and keep you well. Asante sana.
Thank you.
Thank you, Nagulai. Thank you, team.
Bye.
We value you all the best. Thank you.